Welcome back to Let's Play Xenogears. In the last episode, I made a bit of a mistake. I forgot that it was best to have Ellie in your crew. Not because she's good with the battles or anything, but because the plot sort of is best when she is here. Because of what she does right now. Brought Ellie along, like I did the first time. Doc would have gone in here and activated this computer, but because we have Ellie in her crew, she goes in here and she does all this and has all the bizarre dialogue. Because a long time ago, a bunch of people died in here. This girl, basically, is what the Ethos were after. And it's what Solaris wants. Okay, now we have a battle with these two mismatched idiots. Although they are the elements, they are our ancestors and guard, just like Doc and Sigurd and all of them. They used to be the elements as well. It's best to have Elena in your crew because of the plot points that she has. She's not really good in a battle against these two. And also Rico. The only reason why I bring him along is because I don't use him a whole lot in the game, and I wanted to vary it up a little bit. And as you can see, their first attack basically wiped out two of my party members and left Doc almost dead. Not exactly the best team I should go up against these two with. No. Now we're going to be trapped in this battle for a little bit. So let's go back and talk about a little bit about what we had just seen. Obviously, Ellie knew something. She was able to activate the computer, and she basically knew the girl was in that tank. Now, this girl is not a real human being. She's a manufactured human. She was manufactured around 4,000 years ago, back when the facility was still active. As a science trainer, her body is really just a kind of vessel for these nanomachines, these tiny little robots, and these robots have obviously a bunch of uses. They can build almost anything they want, and if you have them in your body, they can heal you very quickly. Obviously, the military usefulness of these robots is obvious. But they're quite useful. When it comes to pure military, what does Solaris have to worry about? They basically control the world. You can see what they're doing. They have the Ethos behind that whole thing. They basically maintain by telling you that they already have nanomachines, but they are primitive by comparison to the ones that exist in this world. So, the old nanomachines they had were basically incapable of working as efficiently, building anything out of anything. The new ones are far superior. They're far older, though. And these are probably the only ones that actually exist in the world. Back to the question about how Ellie knew about it. Unfortunately, it's a little bit too early in the story to really discuss that in detail. But we can basically see that there's a lot more to Ellie than even she knows. Pink one is the way. Pink white one is the more mature of the two. Win. You can see by the way the white one's name is like Tolerant or something like that. She's like really messed up. Solaris using their like nanobots, so they have really done a number on her. She's basically like half a robot, like Darth Vader. You see a couple of attacks that she does here, like she steps forward and takes her arm off and shoots a laser out of her arm.
Haas! Haas!
Battle's dragging out. again. Resurrect him. Okay, this will... They're just gonna leave now. And we're gonna... Well, we're not gonna chase them down. We have to chase down Bishop Stone.
Okay, go with it.